Alrighty, let's talk a little bit about gross anatomy. Everything on this page is some really basic background information that is going to carry you through the rest of the semester. So we really do need to cover everything on this page, okay? When we talk about gross anatomy pertaining to this particular module, what we're talking now about are regional terms, directional terms, sections, planes. So let's get started. Standard anatomical position is a very specific position that the body adopts. Okay, so you may have always wondered, why are all anatomy pictures with the guy standing up with his palms facing forward, or the gal and her feet facing forward, standing, sort of very military-like? Well, that's because this is a very specific position that the body has, so that when we talk about the body, you and I and people across the globe are all referring to the exact same location and structure. No matter where we are, no matter how you find the body, if the body's lying down, if for some reason the forearm is pronated or the feet are inverted or everted, we always have a sort of standard terminology that we can use. And this is called standard anatomical position. And it's very clear: standing, not lying down. So even if someone cannot stand and they're wheelchair bound, you would still talk about their body, if you were going to write a report, about using them in standard anatomical position, so that the anterior surface of their body is the anterior surface. It doesn't matter if they're seated or standing, but you would talk about the body as if it was in the standing position. Hopefully that makes sense. So it's standing, body erect, so sit, you know, head up, not, you know, lagging to the side, palms facing forward, thumbs facing away from the body, feet about shoulder width apart, pointing forward. And this is now a way we can talk about the body. So it's sort of like a default setting that we all use. This is pretty basic. We divide the skeleton into two subdivisions, the axial skeleton and the appendicular skeleton. The axial skeleton is composed of the skull, the vertebral column, and the rib cage, the thoracic cage. The appendicular skeleton, or appendages, refers to, of course, your appendages, so your arms and your legs, plus there's this word called girdles, the girdles that hold those appendages to the axial skeleton. So your pectoral girdle is the scapula and clavicle on either side. And the pelvic girdle is the os coxa, or the coxal bones, the two coxal bones, which are made up of three individual bones. You'll see these two terms when we do the skeletal system, because we sort of divide learning the skeleton into these two subdivisions. It's a lot of material to learn, so this is sort of a basic way that we divide it. So you have your axial skeleton and your appendicular skeleton. Regional terms are important to know because, well, frankly, we want to sound professional when we are talking about anatomy, don't we? So we don't want to say belly button anymore. We want to say umbilicus. Or instead of saying the elbow, we would say the olecranon. Or instead of saying the mouth, we might say the oris. The calf would be the sura, etc. You can take a look at this picture, which I've also provided in your assignment for this module. And it's going to be important to know all of these regional terms, so that when we move forward and you have to write discussions about a particular case study, you would want to use this correct regional term or the correct anatomical term for body parts instead of using the common term. Directional terms are really important. So no longer do we say front and back, top, bottom, up, down, in, out. These are just terms that don't suffice when we're talking about anatomy. We want to sound professional. We want to sound like we know what we're talking about. So we need to use these directional terms. Directional terms usually come in twos. So you have anterior, and then you have posterior. You have superior, and then you have inferior. Two sets of terms that are a little complicated are proximal and distal, and medial and lateral. Proximal and distal refer to your appendages. We always use proximal and distal when we're talking about something on your arm or on your leg. You don't say superior and inferior. You would never say, and I'm just going to use the common terms for now, we would never say that the elbow is superior to the wrist. We would say that the elbow is proximal to the wrist. It's closer to your body than your wrist is. We would also maybe say that your elbow is distal to your shoulder because your elbow is further away from your body than your shoulder. If we're talking about the lower body, we might say the knee is distal to the thigh, or we could say the knee is proximal to the foot, okay? Medial and lateral refer to the plane, the side-to-side plane, which we're going to call the frontal plane. Medial means closer to your midline. Medial is like at your belly button. So if you were to draw a line from your nose, down your mouth, through your chin, through your sternum, through your belly button, through your groin, and create two pieces of you, a right and a left piece, that would be cutting you into the right and the left. And so medial would be closer to that midline at the center. Lateral is further away. So we would say, for example, the ears are lateral to the nose. Or we would say, let's see, the belly button is medial to the hips, something like that. Okay, so those are terms that are a little confusing. It takes a little practice. The other ones are easy, right, left, superior, inferior, anterior, posterior. Superficial and deep we use on a structure that's sort of orb-shaped, like something round, like your head or your whole body. We'll use superficial and deep. Work through that quiz that I've provided to help you learn the directional terms. Our last sort of gross anatomical topic refers to the planes and sections that we use. When we dissect, for example, in the lab, you would need to know if you're going to cut something in the middle, down the sides, sort of to create a top and a bottom piece. It just sort of depends on what you want to look at. And so we need to know the names of these sections. There are three primary sections: sagittal, which would cut the body into a right and a left piece. Frontal section would cut something into an anterior and a posterior piece. And a transverse section, also called a cross section, would cut something into a top and a bottom piece or a superior and inferior piece, unless you're talking about the appendage, and it would be a proximal and a distal piece. So all of these gross anatomical terms are really just important for moving forward throughout the rest of the semester. We're going to talk about the medial epicondyle and the lateral epicondyle. We're going to talk about proximal structures, distal structures. And so having these terms at hand, just easily used, is a goal for us for this unit. Alrighty.